Hi, good morning children. Welcome back again. So let us discuss another very important chapter in cell biology, that is the remaining part of our cancer topic, that is causes of cancer. Okay, so you know now familiar with how cancer cells are forming, how a cells become cancerous, what is metastasis, neoplastic, everything you studied, and what are the properties of cancer cells, how they invade, everything you studied. Okay, now let us discuss what are the causes of cancer. Okay, so there are so many factors, and many of the scientists and researchers are going on to know the reasons of cancer. Okay, so there are so many causes, so we can classify them into different groups like external factors, internal factors, as well as certain initiators and promoters. Okay, so that is internal. So what are the various external factors? You know, in there are so many cancer awareness programs happening in our surroundings, and through that we all aware about most of the cancers are caused by so many chemicals, that is external agents that we are exposing daily, radiations, then our change in our lifestyle, in the modern lifestyle, people actually they modified their food habits and everything. So they included so many fast food, etc., into their daily diet, so that may lead to cancer, and also external viruses, then chemicals, pesticides, etc., and so many internal factors like hormones, then our immune conditions, and inherited mutations, etc. So these are all result in cancer. Okay, so let us discuss one by one. And initiators and promoters, what are initiators and promoters? You know, initiators cause irreversible changes to DNA. Okay, so there are changes caused by mutations, and that increases cancer risk. Okay, so they initiate the irreversible changes. Okay, the changes cannot be rectified, so they are irreversible changes in the DNA. Okay, that may lead to cancer. And promotion is actually the next step, that is a two stage model of cancer development. Once a cell being mutated by an external agent or an initiator, then it is promoted by promoters. Okay, so that are, they are susceptible to the effects of promoters, so its intensity may increases. So they are the initiators and the promoters. Okay, and next, there are so many reasons in the external factors while discussing. We have to give importance to these factors, that is occupational and environmental factors. There are so many people who are working in such an environment that may cause cancer, leading to cancer. For example, you know, you may be heard about silicosis, asbestosis, bagasosis. These are all may result due to the exposure to a particular type of agents, or the conditions where they are doing their job. Okay, so they are totally known as occupational hazards. There may be short term hazards and long term hazards. Okay, so most of the long term hazards are finally result in cancer. Okay, so short term hazards are generally curable, like sort of cough, allergy, asthma, etc. But when its intensity goes on increasing and such agents accumulated in the body, that may leads to that long term hazards, that especially finally it results in cancer. Okay, so there are some agents like asbestos, nickel, chromate, benzene, arsenic, radioactive substances, coltas, then herbicides, pesticides, etc. Even farmers, those who are doing large scale cultivation, may have the chances of exposed to cancer. For example, applying herbicides and pesticides in their field. That is why we are preferring that organic farming. Okay, so this may also lead to cancer. And so many chemicals like asbestos, nickel, etc., that is coming, that may be inhaled during their work. That is known as occupational and environmental factors. These people are at a high risk. And next is, you can see in this image how this asbestos fiber enter. Asbestos fiber in this picture, you can see these are the asbestos fiber. So this asbestos fiber enter into the tissue, okay, organ lining. See through the mouth to our larynx, that tract, and finally accumulate in the lungs. Okay, and may result in different types of cancer. So larynx may be affected, that is laryngeal cancer. Then mesothelioma may occur in the lungs or in the abdomen or in the heart of testes, or the major cases it may result in lung cancer, and even the chances of ovarian cancer is high. You know, once it is formed, that may be circulated through the blood and may cause tumor in other parts of the body also. Okay, so this is a severe condition. Then another factor is the social and psychological factors, stress mainly. Okay, so they may be resulted in the several type of cancers. You know, sleeping disorders, and also the diet disorders, and all these may affect our immune system. That may also result into cancer. Then chemicals in our food. Okay, so we people nowadays, the modern style of eating, okay, we prefer the fast food, and we prefer usually the packed food. Okay, so this may also result in certain type of cancer. For example, one important components, that is sodium nitrate, that we are used as preservatives in our food. Okay, that may form a potential carcinogen. What is carcinogen? The cancer causing chemicals. Okay, so this may lead to a potential carcinogen, namely nitrosamine. Okay, and sodium citrate, that sodium citrate is also applying in our food. That may be not that much dangerous, but sodium nitrate available in used in different forms in our food items. Usually they are using to prevent botulism. You know, that's a type of fungal poisoning. Okay, so in order to prevent botulism, people the industries use this type of food, and industries use sodium nitrate. Okay, and also pesticide and herbicide residues. Usually most of the people are unaware about it. So farmers and also some people are residing, they may be not at all educated. Those people usually, I have seen that people using these bottles of pesticides and fertilizers after cleaning, they use these bottles for storing their food items like sugar, tea, etc. So, you know, these bottles even have the remains of these toxic chemicals. So that may be entering our body through touch, through contact or through our food. So their residues may be there. So this may, through any way, this may enter into our body, that are all carcinogenic. Okay. So you can see it's in this image. So while looking into the nutrition facts and cover of the content of so many items, you can see the sodium nitrate is an important content. Okay. So kindly avoid such food items that are long-term stored food items. Okay. Now, another important point is viral factor. So there are so many viruses, you know, what are oncogenes? So genes that cause diseases. So there are certain viruses that causing, like a papilloma virus, herpes virus. Okay, they involved in the development of cancer, severe cancers like leukemia, Hodgkin's disease, cervical cancer, etc. Okay, so some examples are Epstein-Barr virus. So that and also human papilloma virus. That's the most dangerous virus nowadays spreading, and that causes genital warts. So may result in cervical cancer, especially females are affected. And another one is Helicobacter pylori, causing ulcers that may result into the stomach cancer. So these are very recently widely spreading viruses in our body. Okay, now look into this some examples. Human papilloma viruses. So papilloma viruses are actually a group of viruses. Different types are there. Usually 91% of women with cervical cancer may result due to this virus. Okay, so 51 types are identified. So some common type are 6 and virus type 6 and 11. Okay, so pap test is usually recommended to test the presence of human papilloma virus. Okay, especially ladies will be affected. And there are other type like causing diseases. These also cause diseases into the squamous cell carcinoma. The larynx, esophagus and lungs also affected by this virus. So the second group is human polyoma virus. Result the cancer sarcoma. Okay. Then simian virus 40 result in leukemia. Adenovirus. Then herpes virus. Hepatitis B virus, etc. Okay, and viral mainly include these all contain viral oncogenes. Okay, cancer causing genes. So viruses are actually causing a problem to all living organisms, especially in other organisms also you can see this, but we only look upon the conditions in human beings. So these are all nowadays more common, and you know about COVID viruses. Okay, So these are all most dangerous than that COVID viruses also. Okay. See the image of the three-dimensional model of human papilloma virus. So it having a capsid protein and viral nucleic acid. Okay. And some images of cancer causing pathogens like Helicobacter pylori, I already told you, causing cancer, colon cancer, hepatitis B viruses, hepatitis C viruses, and human papilloma viruses, HPV. All these are very common nowadays causing cancer. Okay. Now, another some important factors are medical factors. Medical factors include we undergo some type of exposure to radiations, scanning, MRI, etc. And also the treatment we are taken for some other diseases like medicines like diethylbestrol, DES, diethylstilbestrol. This is 1940 to 1916. This commonly used to control bleeding during the time of pregnancy. So the daughters of the mothers that used this may have found to have increased risk of cancer. Then estrogen supplementation, then chemotherapy. That we all know, chemotherapy in one part may lead to cancer in other part also. So this may lead to cancer. So medical treatments, some of the medical treatments may also result in cancer in future or to the fetal, through the fetus to the next generation. Okay. Then this, you can see in this pie diagram, the global causes of cancer. So which one will be the highest one? So 30% is smoking and alcohol use. Okay. Usually lung cancer will be the main result and liver also affected alcoholic use. And you can see 30 to 35%, that is the highest percentage, is mainly due to the studies revealed that unbalanced diet. Okay. So one third of all cancer death is due to high glycemic carbohydrates, too many calories, then obesity, lack of physical activity, etc. So we can in one way we can control the causes of cancer. We can avoid the causes of cancer. How you can avoid? When you are practicing daily physical exercises, that is, you can do daily exercises. You can walk, you can do some jogging, you can do skipping, cycling, and so many such exercises, that fat dissolving type of exercises, reducing your calories. So usually people in Kerala prefer the rice. So over consumption of carbohydrates may also causes this type of problems. So include all types of food items. Not only stick on to one particular type of food item. So a variety of food items you prefer, that may result to you, that may result in your healthy health, and also you can avoid the causes of cancer. Okay. So an unbalanced diet is a main result. So control it. Then 1% pollution is the only 1%, 2% only occupation. Okay. So majority of the people involved in white collar jobs and other jobs. So only a very few percentage having such exposure to occupational hazards. But major chances are due to our unbalanced diet. Okay. Then hormones and the result to cancer is only 80 to 20%. And remaining 18 to 20% is infections. Okay. Death occur in poor countries due to hepatitis B, human papilloma virus, HIV, etc. But there are so many controlling system, hygienic system that we can follow. Then that may through that we can avoid this type of viral infections. Okay. So when we take care, we can control the occurrence of cancer. Okay. And next is, let us discuss some important aspects of food. What type of food we have to eat, through that how we can control cancer. Okay. So you know, we are already heard about antioxidants. So antioxidants are there in our food. So it may be a vitamin, it may be a mineral, or it may be a phytochemical, whatever it may, that is available mainly through our food item. So these play an important role, that may neutralize the damage to the body cells. So these are all present in vegetables, fruits, whole grains, beans and nuts. So practice including these items to our food. Okay. So eat more antioxidant containing food items. So why our body needs this? You know, in our body, we have to fight to the free radicals. So that cell against the molecules calling free radicals. Okay. To achieve stability, a free radical scavenges electron from other molecules. that disturb the stability. Okay, so this processes is a chain of processes. Okay, so antioxidants act as a system that defend. Okay, this is a part of this chemical chain that produces more and more free radicals that inflict damage our healthy cells. So the antioxidant defend the body cells against the formation of against a molecule called free radicals. Okay, free radicals scavenges electrons from other molecules. So the process is continuing and protecting our body. Okay, so there are so many types of items content like selenium, so that may reduce the risk of prostate and lung cancer. Then vitamin E available that may also reduces the risk of colon and prostate cancer. Vitamin C help to reduce the risk of stomach cancer. Then so many other vitamins like A, D, E, and also they are all part of these antioxidants that may fight and protect our body. So try to include these items in your food. Okay. So people who eat a mostly plant-based food, vegetables and plenty of fruits, whole grains, beans, etc., nuts, etc., can lower the cancer risk. Okay. Then a diet rich in fruit and vegetables should provide all the antioxidants necessary for good health and reduce cancer. Okay. So your plate should contain a small part of carbohydrates, then a huge sprouted seeds like green gram, then horse gram or Bengal gram, whatever it may. Sprouted one is very good, otherwise that full pulses also. Then other sources like vegetables, then part of fruits or salads, that's it, lemon juice, etc., spread in that raw salads. So all these are should be more than our carbohydrate part. Okay, so a balanced diet you should prefer. Then protein also required, egg, albumin, then certain fishes like small fishes, etc. So that all fight or that all defend. So we can reduce, minimize the risk of cancer at least 20%. Okay. So colorful dish you have to eat. Colorful vegetables. So those contain anthocyanins. Then that food that fight against cancer, including the berries, beans, cruciferous vegetable. You know, cruciferous family. We studied cabbage, cauliflower, and also mustard, etc. Then dark green leafy vegetables, flaxseed, very important one, flaxseed. Usually we people not use flax seeds. This how to use flax seeds, etc., available in now available internet. So you can check it. Then garlic, very important one, you can include in your food daily. Garlic, grapes, grape juice, green tea, soya. Soya is also very important. Soya seeds, then tomatoes, whole grains. All these when you include it in your food, the risk of cancer should be reduced. Then anthocyanins, very important one. That colorful item that may have high antioxidant, prevent cancer of skin, bladder, etc. Then blueberries, fiber containing items, etc., reduces colorectal cancer. That oats, ragi, that are containing high fiber rich food. Then that banana pseudostem, you know, they are also high rich in fiber content. Okay, then ellagic acid containing in all berries. And also vitamin C that I already told you, they are all protectors against the cancer. Then finally, we can say no single food or food substance can protect you against cancer. So you need a variety of items. Okay. So right combination of food, predominantly plant-based diet, eating vegetables, fruits, whole grains and beans will reduce the risk of developing cancer. So try to follow, try to practice these and try to include these in your food items. For a healthy life, you know, where once cancer detected in a part of the body, even if you removed that cancer cell, you used to chemotherapy, there are chances of spreading into other parts, maybe of very high. So initial stages, usually people detecting in the initial stages also having the risk. So practice the eating healthy food. That is the only remedy for this. Okay. So kindly avoid all these food items that are available, easily packed food items. You prefer these burgers, pizzas, and all those items may harm your body. It's no doubt. Okay. then macaronis, like so many items. So kindly avoid all those items, and then sauces available, everything that may damage our body. So the risk of cancer is very high when you use these type of items. So kindly avoid this, go to plant based food items that we can prepare. So you can see in this table, breast cancer factors that decreases risk is engage in physical activities 4 hours per week. Lot of fruits and vegetables you use. Okay, so when you are obese, your obesity, your weight is body mass index, you have to check it. When it is high, then you are using alcohol, hormone replacement therapy, etc. may lead to high risk. Okay, so in this chart you can see type of cancer, colorectal, lung and oral, throat, everything, and also how the risk can be reduced and what are the factors that increase risk. Okay, so go through this chart and study. And you can avoid the your weight, reduce your weight, overweight. That's very important point. Then daily exercise, practice grains, fruit, legumes and so on. Limit refined sugar. White sugar is actually a refined sugar. If you avoid it, that is very good. Okay, then alcoholic drinks, red meat, salted food, fried food, etc. So you can have so many other options. So depend on that. So daily practicing all this means once in a week or month is not a problem, but daily consuming and your consumption rate is very high, that may lead to cancers. Okay, so you won't completely, no need to completely avoid all these items. Once in a week or once in a month or likewise you can practice it, but maximum number of times you try to include plant based food, fibers and mixed varieties of food, especially colored, highly colored vegetables and those containing anthocyanin pigments, passion fruit, beetroot, that spinach. So likewise you include in your food, that may cause a risk of reduce the risk of cancer. Okay, so that's all. And also apply using taking the oral contraceptives, and also some other causes like late menarche, early menopause, having more number of children, etc. may lead to the risk of breast cancer very high. Okay, so that's all for today's class. What we discussed is the factors causing cancer and also the cancer and food. Okay, so what type of food we can practice and how we can reduce the risk of cancer. Okay, so that's all for today's class. And you can add so many points looking into the literature, read so many papers regarding the researchers in cancer, and also thorough well. So study well. So have a nice day. Thank you.